Good morning, students. Let us see how to determine the polarity of an electromagnet. To determine polarity of an electromagnet. Now, as per the rule, if the current enters clockwise, we consider that end of an electromagnet behaving like south pole, whereas if the current enters anti-clockwise, then that end of the magnet will be behaving like north pole. Let us try to understand this with the help of simple experiment. Suppose we have this an electromagnet. Where these are the number of turns of the coil. And let us suppose the two ends of the wire has been connected to the two terminals of the battery. This can be considered as the positive terminal and this the negative terminal. Now let us see which way the current enters. Here this will be the direction of the current. So we can have this direction in each turn and finally to the negative terminal. Now question still comes here that which ends of this electromagnet will behave like south pole and which one will be a north pole. Let us see. When we consider this end, you can see that the wire is turned from the inner side of the electromagnet. For example, if this is an electromagnet, then you find the turning has been made from inside. So whichever we find, let us try to understand this. Here we have taken an electromagnet and let us suppose this we have the turning being done from inside. So we will be use the right hand side. If the current enters in the right direction, and we will be using the left hand if the current enters in the left direction. So here you can see the current is entering in the left side and has been entered from inside. So let us suppose we have this way the current being entered. So when you move your hand in the direction of the current, then it's coming this way. Not from outside it has been turned, it has been turned from inside. So we'll take our fingers from inside itself and we can turn our fingers this way. Now assuming this as the clock, when you turn it this way, you will find your finger is moving clockwise. Okay, so we can consider this as the south pole. Whereas automatically this becomes the north pole. Same way, if suppose the current has been or the turning of the wire has been done from outside, and if the current is moving or the turning has been done from outside and the current is also moving in the upward direction, not this way what I showed you just now, but in the reverse direction. Now in that case you have also to rotate your finger in the same way. Now this time we can rotate it this way, and when you assume this as the clock, your finger is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction. So in that case this end would be the north pole. Similarly, the current goes in the left direction, we'll be using the left side or the left fingers. If the current enters from inside, we will be rotating our fingers from inside, and if the current is turned outside, then we'll be rotating from outside. Now this time we'll assume this as the clock, and accordingly whether it has been rotating outside or inside, accordingly we are going to decide about the polarity of the magnet. So I hope it is clear. We can determine using the direction of the current flowing. If it enters clockwise, the end of the magnet will be a south pole, and if it enters anti-clockwise, the end will be north pole. Now let us take one question from the exercise, that is from exercise 10b, question number 5, where you can see the coil has been shown. This is the question, and you can understand from the battery itself, from the terminal of the battery itself, which direction the current is flowing. Here in this figure, it is flowing in the left side. So you have to use your left hand or left finger. Now, if I can show you, the current is flowing not from inside of the end of the electromagnet, but it is flowing from outside. So similarly, if you consider this, you can see it is moving from outside. So we will also accordingly move our fingers. Had the current been moved from inside, we would have moved from inside. According to this question, we will be moving our finger outside. So when you are moving it outside this way, the finger moves. Assuming this as the clock, we can understand now which direction the finger is rotating. It is in the anti-clockwise direction. So the left side of, or the end which is X there, will act as the south pole, and Y will be the north pole. Now coming to the previous exercise, that is exercise 10A, question number 20, where you have to show the magnetic field lines between the two magnets. So in question number 20, there are two magnets given. In the first magnet, you can see where the two same poles are facing each other. I'll show you in question number 20A, where there are two poles facing each other, say north pole and north pole. The other two ends are south pole. Now in this case, the magnetic field lines can be shown this way. Now you can mark the direction of the magnetic field lines. We have this. Second is the case where the two poles are, two opposite poles are facing each other. So let us have that also. When the two opposite poles here we have, where the two opposite poles are facing each other, in this case the magnetic field lines can be shown using this. This way the magnetic field lines can be drawn. Now the direction so far is concerned, you know that the direction, so the magnetic field lines direction is always from the north to the south pole. So we can have the arrow this way. So I hope the direction of magnetic field lines are clear to you. whenever there will be two magnets facing opposite to each other, or the two magnets where the light poles are facing each other, accordingly the magnetic field lines should be drawn. I have shown you here also. So since we have completed the chapter, your homework will be to complete these two exercises. Thank you.